Hey, thank you for tuning in to Dave and Joe Liberty Stand. We are at DCB Auto.
Yep.
Service still.
Everything.
Got a
transmission fixers.
Great energy here at the shop. And yeah. So, Dave, we were talking about
Second Amendment. We're going to continue with this. So far, we have decided, I think, and nobody should. It's not time to talk yet, guys. That if you have committed a felony and it wasn't a violent one or whatever, you know, well, even if it was, if you went to prison and you get out in 2, 5, 15, 20 years, whatever it is, you're done. You know, you still got to be on probation or maybe a halfway house in between. And as soon as you're done with all that, you're a citizen again. Did everybody pretty much just clap or not?
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay. We agree with that. And then you have the right to bear
arms. Well, of course, that's the point. But
after that.
I don't agree.
No, wait, we're not there yet.
Okay,
so anyway, let's review again in case you didn't see the last show, the Second Amendment.
Second Amendment says.
And then if you want to share your comments a bit.
I love the glasses, man. They're so sexy.
Second Amendment. A well-regulated militia being necessary to the security of a free state, the right of the people to keep and bear arms shall not be infringed.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
So go ahead. Right. Cindy was going
to. It has nothing to do with a felony there for a moment.
There we go.
No, we were kind of talking about the fact that you had mentioned that if somebody has a privately owned business,
yes, right.
They can make it their policy.
It's their right.
It is their right to say, I don't want firearms on my premises.
Right.
Now, by the law of Indiana where we're at, you can have your firearm.
Where we at?
Yeah. You like the grammar, don't you?
That's
where we are. Who's yours?
Get a little good.
Yeah.
Where we are at.
I'm just teasing.
No, I'm a grammar Nazi. I can't.
We got time.
I'm shocked she said it.
Google it's bigly. Right? Yeah, I'm sorry.
It's going to be huge.
Yeah.
You
couldn't help it. So, in the state of Indiana, the law is that you can have your firearm in your vehicle at your job, as long as it's locked and secured in your vehicle, which is, I believe, glove box or your trunk. But there are places that privately own businesses that they don't, you know, that's their policy. I happen to work for one of them. It is her policy that you cannot carry on her premises. And I respect that.
Employees.
I've had employees. I've had people, you know, walk in that have their firearms on their hips and it does not bother me a bit. I would prefer.
Do you feel safer?
I would feel safer if I could carry my firearm to work.
Okay, fair enough. But as soon as you see a sidearm, you're like, ah, yay.
Well, and when I see someone with a sidearm.
All right, girls, let Jeff go. Jeff, please.
And with her, just like me, okay, I work for a company, I am on the road. My company will not allow me to carry while I travel. So I don't have a place, it's got to stay at home. Mm-hmm. But I go to schools, I work on equipment in different places. So I'm in many of situations. So the other thing, like what she was bringing up about, you know, do you feel safer? What most people don't understand is, somebody is carrying a firearm, they are willing to stand between you and another person.
The wrong person.
They're making themselves target number
one. Well, that's why I feel so safe.
Yeah, well.
Because I know if they're willing to show their weapon, they're willing to use it appropriately.
You hope.
But I would never.
If somebody's carrying a weapon, that's different than holstering, carrying a weapon.
You mean concealed versus, is that you're saying?
My favorite is, I like seeing it.
You want to see it on somebody?
I want to freaking see somebody walk into a VP and go, okay, you know what? Somebody's back there looking at beer and they've got an unconcealed weapon. And then I got the dude that's up there, or chick.
Time constraints. We got to let everybody talk.
You. All right. I have a story kind of going based on what she said about how she likes to see the gun. She wants to see the people at it. I actually used to drive for a food service company here locally, and I would have to go around campus, pick food up, take the people. So I was hitting restaurants and going to the resident halls, and I would carry my firearm while I was there because, you know, at night you hear about the people coming up, getting hit over the head, and they take their phone and they run.
Right.
Well, my job is ran through my phone. I have it in my hand. I'm walking on the street, find the address. It's all the time visible in my hand. So I'm a target for that.
Or not. Or so,
well,
not.
Well, you're concealed, though, right?
So,
or
carry.
Not.
If you're now, a bad guy,
I didn't.
First person you're going for.
If I'm in fucking camo, excuse me.
if she caught herself.
I wore my sweatshirt or something and it came up, I wasn't like pulling it down. I covered it. If it happened to show, it showed. It's fine. I have a permit. I'm allowed to pick which one. Now,
yeah.
I was at a resident hall and went into the set of double doors to get the food to the person. They opened the door. I went inside, handed the food, and then left. I got a call at 3 in the morning from Purdue police say, hey, I heard
no.
Do you work for so-and-so? I said, yeah. They say,
no.
Are you carrying? I said, yes, and I have a lifetime permit. Why do you ask? Well, we heard you're in such and such hall, and someone called and
someone
complained
saw.
About it. I said, and? I it's not a gun free zone.
You didn't pull
zone.
It out and
no.
Stick
and
them
said,
up.
Well, I'm not here to argue about your rights.
Yeah.
I said, well, then what's
eat
going
it.
On?
Right. What's
and he said, well, it's against the school's policy for you to carry the resident.
Well, that's very.
I said, I've been here my whole life. I have seen zero checkpoints coming in or out of campus where you guys hand out their handbooks to know the rules of
or
that.
Sign.
I
well,
am not
or
signs. There's no
post
signs
or, right.
I said, if you want me to not do that, put a sign up.
Right.
Or
exactly.
Make sure that all these companies have that literature because
yeah.
He goes, well, I'm not going to just
Second
just
Amendment,
sure
Second Amendment,
oh, okay.
Second Amendment.
Well, can I say something real
quick? Second Amendment,
said,
well, Second Amendment.
Have to conceal it. And he goes, well, then just have them meet you outside.
Oh.
And that's the alternative. And
Second
I wasn't
Amendment.
In any trouble. He didn't want to argue with me about it. He just said,
yeah.
Hey, these are your options. Please abide by one of them.
Well, can I say
no,
something
no.
Real quick?
Okay, real quick.
Well, I was just going to say, because I'm not used to seeing, like, I know some states
know
people carry, right?
In Texas,
out.
Everybody.
Well, for me, and Quentin, you guys were talking earlier about, you know, how we all respond differently, and we do.
Yeah.
I'll tell you, honestly, I have a concealed carry license, lifetime, but to see it on the outside, it makes me uncomfortable. Once we
cop
see that
and
more
or
often,
civilian and cop.
Just, but I think if once we see it more and more and more, we would get used to it. But I think culturally in
Lafayette,
you don't see that very often. Go ahead.
Okay, bye.
You have a comment?
Yes, I have a lot of comments.
Quentin?
The question I've got is I've heard all of you talk about that you feel safer, you feel more secure when you see the firearm.
I just said I don't.
Okay. And I have something to say to that.
What
okay.
is, you know, with the, for those that have their permits, one, you see the weapon. Two, how do you know I carry? And three, how do you know that I know how to use that?
That's
right.
That
oh, yeah.
Okay, so it all kind of ties
well,
together.
Well, to get a concealed carry weapon permit, you've got to go through a class.
Not in Indiana. I've got
okay,
one, never went through a class.
All right, we're getting
in again. 6 hours, I can have a pistol, put it in a holster on my hip, and nobody here would know the difference.
Yes.
Right.
If I have a permit, if I know how to use
right.
it, or if it's legal.
Well, and the nice thing, I think, crime is lowered when people are allowed to carry.
Yes.
Well, you can look it up.
I'm going to have to say, if there are 3 out of 5 people that is showing a concealed.
Yeah.
Hurry, hey, we got less.
Criminals are not going to.
Exactly.
Right.
Okay,
hold on.
My response to you is, you know, you say you like to see it on their hip, and it makes you feel safe. But my whole thing is if I'm going to carry, you're not going to know it.
Fair enough. I would
and the reason behind that, to back that up,
so that
you walk through the door, I'm 260 pounds, I look like I'm a biker, I'm the guy that crawled out from underneath the rock and the rock. Okay? You come in and you go to think, I am number one prime target. If I don't have a gun and you see somebody else has got a gun, I've got an opportunity to hopefully have the wherewithal to get that shot off.
Fair enough, me too.
Well, and
I'm a manner of striker, so I carried one all the time. with me on post.
No, we're doing 10 minutes.
I'm just putting it out there. I carried all the time, and I felt very protected.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Could I kill you? I don't know.
Right.
I'm going back.
That's a good question. I don't know. Right there.
Last thought of the show is from me.
Oh!
That guy.
Go ahead. Whatever.
I'm going to the, do you prefer that somebody has it concealed or do you feel better?
Are you talking about gun or guns. Something else?
Wow.
I don't want to be a part of that.
Shut up!
That's another show.
Nobody's talking no more.
Time constraints.
Go ahead.
Hit done.
Go ahead.
You're grounded. Okay. As a carrier, I prefer to keep it concealed. I don't want to be a target. But exactly. It is ultimately up to the decision of the person to carry.
Apparently, in Indiana,
it's not what makes other people feel better. It's what makes you, as the carrier, feel better. And we have to go. Bye.